What up, guys? Welcome back to the second episode of the Mavic Pro Platinum review, and thanks for tuning back in. So this little birdie here has more in store for us than it shows us at the beginning, and it looks like DJI withheld some information about the differences between the Mavic Pro Platinum and the legacy Mavic Pro. In this episode, I will cover all the technical differences between the new Mavic Pro Platinum versus the old Mavic Pro, and this will include all the noise and sound level differences between the two drones, and also I will give you a footage review between the two drones. And I don't want to spoil anything, but there is actually a difference. So without further ado, let's jump right in. Fast forward, it's the next morning, and since I wasn't able to pit these two against each other yesterday, I will give you a comparison between the picture quality of the old Mavic versus the new one. So let's do this. I completed my side-by-side comparison rig, and this will be it. So I know it looks a bit medieval and it's a bit improvised, but it will do, and we'll see whether there is a difference in the image quality of the new Mavic Pro Platinum versus the old Mavic Pro. So
I removed the filters from both drones, and I also adjusted the settings so that both of them are running under the same conditions. At a first glance, both feeds look identical. But when you take a closer look, you will notice that there is actually a bit of a difference within the sharpness between the Platinum and the Pro. In a previous episode, I showed you how to adjust properly the sharpness settings of the DJI Mavic Pro, and this also applies for the Platinum. And since I thought that it was an error of mine with the sharpness of the Platinum compared to the Pro, I redid the whole scene multiple times in order to rule out any human error, and the results were always the same, so there is a sharpness difference.
Okay, so much for the image quality. What about the sound of the different Mavics? And I noticed something weird with the startup sound, so see for yourself.
So far, so good. Is it just me, or does that sound a bit off?
Okay, so let's talk about one of the biggest improvements with the new Mavic. And this will be definitely the whole noise thing of the Mavic. With the new Platinum, they introduced new motors, and those two motors bring you two big improvements. One is the new Mavic Pro Platinum is way quieter than the old Mavic Pro. Two being the sound frequency of the Mavic. So the new Mavic Pro Platinum has a more deeper buzzing and not an angry beehive buzzing that the old Mavic Pro had.
Let's begin our comparison with the old Mavic Pro, and make sure you pay attention on how the old motors are starting up. Now here is a little goodie, this is the old Mavic Pro with low noise propellers. Now this is the Platinum, and pay attention on how the new motors are spinning up. In this comparison, I'm playing the sound of the individual drone, and I'm also showing you side by side the different sound level meters I got from the different drones. You have to take the results with the low noise propellers with a grain of salt, cause on that day it was really windy, so there is a bit of tolerance in there. With the graphs, we are even able to visualize the difference between the individual drones. Especially if you take a look at the graph of the Platinum, you will see that on the higher frequency range, the graph is way lower than on the other ones. And this also explains why the Platinum has a deeper motor sound than the legacy Mavic. If you take a look at the Mavic with the low noise propellers, you will also notice that there is an improvement within the sound frequencies, but it is not as high as it is with the Platinum.
So what does that mean in real life? The new Mavic is quieter, and with the new sound, people will not hear you from as far away as before, so you automatically will not disturb all the people around you when you're flying somewhere outside and there may be people out there. Now let's talk about the visual differences between the old and the new Mavic. And I know some people think that the color of a drone doesn't matter, but in my opinion, the old Mavic was way easier to spot while flying. And since at the moment a lot of legal regulations are changing from you can fly as far as you want to you are only allowed to fly up on sight, so with a darker drone, in my opinion, it's easier to spot it within 100 meters. But with a more brighter drone, this will be definitely harder. And just a few days ago, DJI released the old Mavic, so this one without the new motors, without the new propellers, in white. So how this is going to work out, I don't know. And since this body is way smaller than the one from the Phantoms, I think this one will be hard to spot in the alpine white color theme of DJI. So with the new color and the new motors, the new Mavic Pro Platinum is kind of like a more stealthy drone than the Mavic Pro was.
After all these comparisons, what do you think about the new low noise propellers in combination with the new motors? Is this something you would spend extra money on, or are you going to save some money and going for the old legacy Mavic? And what do you think about the increased sharpness within the Platinum? Why did DJI not tell us that they kinda tweaked this one here? So as my final verdict for the DJI Mavic Pro Platinum, DJI's roadmap at the moment is kinda confusing. They are focusing on colors right now and not on new features and innovation and stuff. Well, it's not completely true. They just released new firmware for the Mavic Pro for the panel shots. So in the next episode, I will definitely cover the new panoramic shooting mode, but nevertheless, there is actually not much of improvement within the new Platinum, aside from the bit of sharpness and the better noise. I think they could have done better, but still, it's a really decent drone. If I'm at the moment looking for a new drone and I find the Platinum for the right price, I would rather go for the Platinum than for the legacy Mavic. Why DJI decided to release new Mavics like the Alpine White Mavic with the old stock propellers and the old motors, this is a complete mystery to me. And I hope they will clarify in the near future what they have in store for the Mavic. At the moment, it kind of feels like they have too many spare parts in stock and they are just spray painting them and shipping them off as new versions. So when it comes to the downside of the Mavic family, they are still there. So the focus is still a pain in the ass to figure out. And if you're having trouble finding the right focus on your Mavic, I encourage you to check out my other tutorial on how to get the focus right on the Mavic. And with that said, I still think that the Mavic is at the moment still the most versatile drone that is on the market right now, and also the most reliable and the one with the most features. So I hope this comparison between the old Mavic Pro versus the new Mavic Pro Platinum was helpful for you, and it kind of helped you to decide whether it's worth it to spend the extra buck on the new Platinum. And if you enjoyed today's episode, don't forget to hit the like button and also make sure to subscribe to my channel so you can stay up to date whenever I do new drone related stuff like this today. So thank you for watching and see you next time.